Hey foodies, welcome to Cooking Shooking. How are you guys doing? A very happy Independence Day to all of you. Let's celebrate our Independence Day with our Indian flag inspired dish, a sweet dish. I guess that's how we should celebrate it. So we are going to make a Tiranga Barfi today, a very easy recipe to make. Basically, it's going to be a mawa barfi with a flavor of saffron, coconut and pistachios. Let's begin making it now. For making the Tiranga Barfi, you need to prepare a few things before you start the recipe. So 3 bowls, 3 spoons, keep it aside. Take a cake tin and apply a butter paper in it as well. I'm using a 5-inch square cake tin right now. Now let's begin the recipe. In a cold pan, I'm going to add in about 3 tablespoons of ghee. This is pure ghee. I'm going to next add in about 1 cup of milk. This is room temperature milk, and we are going to slowly add in the milk powder to this. Here I have got about 200 grams of milk powder, which is basically 2 cups of milk powder. We are going to add little at a time and start mixing it all together. Once again, remember this is a cold pan and not a hot pan. Once all the ingredients are well mixed, we are going to heat it up in medium flame and start mixing it around continuously until it starts forming a lump or mawa. It will take about 5 to 6 minutes to cook it down. After 5 minutes, this has started to clump up and looks good. Now I'm going to add in about half a cup of sugar to this. I'm using normal granulated sugar and start mixing it again. This will slightly loosen up again and start leaving some moisture, but that's totally fine. We're going to cook it until it starts leaving the sides of the pan, which will take about 3 to 4 more minutes. Be sure to keep rubbing and pressing the mawa against the sides of the pan to prevent any lump formation. After about 4 minutes, this is looking good to me. As you can see, this has started to form into a lump and has started leaving the sides of the pan. Looking good to me, going to turn off the flame and start dividing it into 3 bowls. Try to divide this mixture as evenly as possible. If you have a weight scale, you can use that as well. Perfect. Now for the green color, we're going to take some pistachio paste. Basically, I took about 4 to 5 tablespoons of pistachios or pista, boiled it and blended it into a smooth paste. Going to add about 2 tablespoons of it at first and start mixing it until we get a good green color. You can add more or less, totally up to your preference. The green layer is looking good. Now we're going to work on the white layer. For the white layer, it's a pretty simple process. Take about 3 to 4 tablespoons of grated coconut and add it to this. I'm using dry coconut, you can use fresh as well. Perfect. Now we're going to work on the orange layer. The quesadilla layer needs to have kesar, so we're going to add some kesar, which is basically saffron. I just soaked about a pinch worth of saffron in some hot water for about 10 minutes and added it to this. Looking perfect now. So here I have the cake tin that we prepared earlier. I'm going to add in the green layer at first. Spread the green layer as evenly as possible and after that start spooning the white layer. The white coconut layer is slightly stiffer, so you need to spoon it instead of spreading it. So this is looking perfect. Now we're going to spoon in the saffron layer as well. I've spreaded the saffron layer into this as well and this is looking great. Now I'm going to keep it aside for about 1 hour to set. You can also keep this in a refrigerator for about 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, our barfi is set. Now we're going to take it out and start cutting it into small slices. The size of barfi is totally your preference. You can keep it bigger or smaller. I like to keep it in small biteable pieces. And for that, I like to break it with my hands. Alrighty, our Tiranga Barfi is also done. So here is my little piece of Tiranga Barfi. Let's try it out. All the flavors so different, yet they are working so well together, just like our Indian cultures and traditions. I hope you try this recipe out and like it just as much as I did. So thank you so much for watching this video. I hope to see you in my next one. Till then, make sure to click the subscribe button and ring the bell icon beside it so that you get notified as soon as I post a new video on the channel.